Hey everyone, Zslayer Dre here, and today we got a Pokemon Direct on the official Pokemon channel on YouTube. There were a few new announcements, some of them we kind of basically already knew about, but we do have the official announcements now. Yeah, a bit of a mixed reaction to it, especially from myself. There's definitely some good. I will say that, there's definitely some good. There's definitely some not so good, to put it lightly, but let's get into it. So first off, they kind of just did like a little trailer. It's the 25th anniversary for Pokemon, so they kind of just really tried to get into everyone's nostalgia and just showed, you know, Pokemon over the years, all the different games and the cards. It was all like the Japanese versions. Yeah, so for me, that does nothing. Great. I mean, it's cool. It's a 25th anniversary, but I'm all about the games. So personally, I've been pretty disappointed by the Pokemon Company over the past few years. It's been kind of like a slippery slope where they've just kind of really gone downhill over time. There's always been issues, but they've really become apparent over the past few years, especially with Sword and Shield. So there was one of two ways they could have gone with it. They could have actually listened to the criticism and really worked to improve the games, or they could have just rushed out some real low effort remake. And yeah. Guess what they did? So let's start with Pokemon Snap. That actually looks really good. It is a kind of a new game. It is obviously inspired by the N64 one. It's one of those games that's not for me, but it looks fine. It looks like a fun game if you're into that. It looks like you can share pictures and stuff. So if you're interested in that, I think that's actually going to be a good title from Pokemon. But like for me personally, I just really care about the mainline games. So, but at least that is, you know, at least there's that side option for people that are interested in it. And it does look like it's a faithful recreation and improves on the original concept. So that's great for people that are into that. So then we got into actually two announces, one being kind of a surprise. So one we definitely knew about. We knew they were doing Diamond and Pearl remakes. And yes, they actually have announced them. They are called Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Pokemon Shining Pearl. And they're coming in late 2021. Obviously, it's going to be in November, probably the second or third week. Like, that's just basically when the big games usually get released. I mean, maybe there's possibly it could go to December, you know, maybe if it got delayed because of the pandemic, you never know. But it looks like they've put basically zero effort into this one, so I don't see why it would get delayed. So my big issue is with it being called a remake and being sold for $60. So if you're seeing the footage on the screen, obviously you will know that this is not some new adventure. This is not a recreation of you know, Pearl and Diamond. This is just a remaster, basically. This is an upscaled 3DS game being sold for full price on the Switch. A game that cost, what, $30 or $40 back in the day is now being sold for almost, if not double, the price. And that is the Pokemon Company in a nutshell for you right now. Now, it looks like they're adding some modern conveniences. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm sure this is the one Pokemon game I didn't play, and I do want to play it. And I actually think it's probably a great game, and I'm going to enjoy playing it. But again, my issues would be calling a remake and being sold for $60. If this was some little thing they toss on the eShop for $15, okay, that's fine. You know, this is a remaster of it, of an old 2006 game. Sure, fine, that's great. Throw it up for $15. Everyone should be able to experience that. But when it looks, the graphically speaking, it looks like an upscale 3DS game. And don't get me wrong, graphics aren't everything gameplay is, but the problem is they were dealing with limitations of the DS, and we're now on the Switch where you can do more. Instead of actually improving and enhancing the game and remaking it in basically using modern technology, we are buying a 2006 DS game with DS problems, with DS limitations. Like I said, it looks like they are adding some quality of life changes that are new to the newer games, but they didn't really go into too much details. It does look like they improved some of the animations, so that is good. They showed very little off, though, so it's hard to say. Like I said, this is really not so much how good the game is going to be that's a problem for me. It's more problem of being called a remake and the price. This is a same problem with Skyward Sword. It should not be $60. It is a huge problem from Nintendo. And like I said in my last video, where is the breaking point for people? When is enough enough? Like, when do you get screwed over so many times that you just can't take it anymore? So it looks like the thing is, the people that are kind of done with Pokemon, they kind of have lost interest. Personally, if I was uncovering this for a gaming channel, I wouldn't have even watched it. Sword and Shield was my limit. That was it for me, as for Pokemon. Which is sad, because I grew up loving that series. And I actually have a video that I've been working on, kind of about that. And I'm still going to be doing it, although some of the things I was saying in it are now known because of this. But the second announcement, or yes, it wasn't the second announcement, but the second kind of surprise game that we got was a huge surprise, and I'm not sure what to think of it, but it initially looks actually pretty amazing, and it's called Pokemon Legends Arceus, and it kind of looks like what everyone's been asking for. It looks more open world. You get to actually have a town that you kind of go back to. They kind of chose three of like the most popular starter Pokemon. The Pokemon actually, like, when they battle, they actually, like, hit each other. You can actually throw Pokemon, like, Pokeballs in the field. Not like Let's Go, but you, like, actually press a button to throw a Pokeball, it looks like. And this looks like the game that we've been asking for. Now, like I said, the Pokemon Company has completely lost my trust. Completely. Especially Game Freak. Like, I do not trust them to make a good game. So I have zero... I actually expect this game to be bad. But initially, and now I hope it's great, because it does look like a lot of things we asked for. I'm just kind of scrolling through the trailer now. It looks like they're using that same game engine from what they use in Sword and Shield. The game looks bad. Like, visually, really bad. Again, gameplay-wise is what matters, but the thing was, the world was so limited because of that engine. Now, it does look like what we're seeing here, it's kind of more open, not like, kind of like Breath of the Wild, I guess. But it really remains to be seen if it's just going to be a series of linear paths with maybe a few open areas. So we really got very little details. But initially, this definitely looks like it has potential. Now, this one, they said it's coming out early 2022. So I don't know if they had this discussion where they just decide where they're going to double dip, where they'll come up with games that are just complete really low effort, and they'll obviously just have those sales that are just going to happen no matter what. People will just buy it just because it has the name Pokemon on it, so they'll come up with those really low effort remasters, really, but they'll call them remakes, sell them for $60, they'll be overpriced, they'll still do the two editions, you know, all that really horrific anti-consumer practices that they do, but then they'll kind of do something a little bit more experimental for the people who aren't unsatisfied. Now, the problem is, Game Freak hasn't shown that they have the talent to actually do anything good lately, so we'll have to see, but I really do hope they pull this off. It looks like if they pull this off, it looks great. Like, obviously, they need some new graphics engine. Like, even for the Switch, this looks terrible. And that's in that itself, it's going to turn people off. And they didn't say if it's like a mainline game or not. Not that it matters. If it's, you know, the gameplay that everyone's looking for, then great. But this is kind of like what we thought we were going to get when we got a, you know, a home console game. And I don't know why they don't do this with the remakes, because the remakes could be so amazing if they did something like this. And that, you know, they're splitting the development team, obviously, now. So how big of an experience is this actually going to be? If it's just like a dinky little experience, then, you know, maybe it's just experimental, let's tag on a test of waters. But if you look at the like to dislike ratio, so Pokemon Legends Arceus, which is basically a new series, right now, it has 36,000 likes, only 1,000 dislikes, okay? And then we have our, you know, standard, low-effort, you know, remakes, I'm saying that with quotation marks, has 25,000 likes and 3.1,000 dislikes. So, like I said, I think that people who are disinterested in Pokemon have left. They're gone. They lost them as customers. So that's why we're seeing such a higher like-to-dislike ratio than it really should be. But you can still see people are way more excited about the Pokemon Legends Arceus than they are about these remakes. And like I said, the only reason why I'm really interested in these remakes is I missed out on them back the day. $60 though for them? I'm not going to pay that. Like, but then at the same time, they never go on sale. Or if they do, it will only go down a few bucks. Which, you know, that really disappoints me. I want to experience that. But I'm just not going to support these terrible business practices anymore. However, Pokemon Legends Arceus, assuming it's an actual full game, you know, which I'm really skeptical on. We'll have to get more details. I will review Legends Arceus. Whether or not I think it looks good is something new. I will buy it to review it. So at very least, I will do that. But if I wasn't getting it to review, I don't know if I would probably wait myself till there was reviews out and till it went on sale, because they have just completely lost my trust. But anyways, let me know down in the comments how you feel about these new announcements. Are you excited for Pokemon Snap? Are you excited about Pokemon Legends Arceus? You know, does this not the direction you think they should go? Let me know down in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you're subscribed and like the video, and I'll see y'all in the next one.